Okay, this sermon is entitled Calvinists Don't Really Believe That Jesus Paid for Sins. I'd like to open up with prayer and then with a few verses. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name, amen. Psalm 119 reads, Blessed are the undefiled in the way, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they that keep his testimonies, and that seek him with the whole heart. They also do no iniquity, they walk in his ways. Now, despite what these unsaved Calvinists are going to say about this, Calvinists do not really believe that Jesus paid for all sins. And that's why I used the all-capitalized shouting word, really, in the midst of all the standard titular words, and that is to show emphasis, because the Calvinist will swear up and down until blue in the face, giving lip service to the idea that Jesus Christ died for sins, yet based on their quotes, their ideologies, and their core beliefs, they don't really believe this at all. When was the last time you heard a Calvinist assert that a person could live like the devil and still go to heaven? They'll never say something like that. Only a free gracer has the temerity to make such a statement, because we believe that Jesus paid for all sins, past, present, and future, like the Bible says, and that includes living like the devil. So my first point and reason why Calvinists don't really believe that Jesus paid for sins is limited atonement. In their wicked system, they believe that Jesus Christ only died for the sins of the elect. That means that there are sins of perhaps millions and billions of people out there that have not been paid for. Now, the Bible teaches that Jesus paid for the sins of the whole world. 1 John chapter 2, let's go ahead and turn there. It reads in verse 1, My little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. So what this is telling us, without a Calvinistic spin being imposed upon the text, is that there are two variant categories of people here. There's the believers in Christ, and then there are the unbelievers of the world. And according to the Bible, Jesus Christ paid for all their sins. That's why he can say he's the propitiation for our sins, and also for the sins of the whole world. Yet in Calvinism, they don't believe this. They believe that Jesus Christ only paid for the sins of the elect. So that means that there are scores of people out there who do not have their sins paid for, and who Jesus did not die for on the cross. And therefore, Calvinists don't really believe that Jesus paid for sins. Now, I have some quotes by Calvinists that prove that they don't believe that Jesus paid for sins. The first quote reads, The carnal Christian teaching is also the mother of one of the most soul-destroying teachings of our day. It suggests that you can take Jesus as your Savior and yet treat obedience to his Lordship as optional. So basically what this stupid unsaved Calvinist is implying is that the carnal Christian teaching, meaning that Christians can remain in an incipient state of carnality or sinfulness, is a soul-destroying teaching. And you can have Jesus as your Savior, they say sardonically, and yet treat obedience to his Lordship as optional, meaning that having Jesus as your Savior is not enough, and that you also have to make him Lord of your life, which is nothing but lordship damnation. This quoter also has implied that the allowance or tolerance for carnal Christianity can destroy your soul, which can only mean that they don't believe that Jesus paid for the sins of carnality. The second quote reads, The truth is that we have no reason to believe that Christ's blood covers our sins in the record of heaven if the Spirit has not changed our hearts on earth. So, according to this Calvinist, they have no reason to believe that Christ's blood covers sins, unless there's some type of change on earth. Now, the free gracer would just say, we believe that Christ's blood covers sins. Yet the Calvinist says, we have no reason to believe that, unless, and then fill in the blank. And then, of course, they're going to add a works-based condition. The third and final quote from a Calvinistic website reads, It is impossible to obtain salvation from Jesus apart from a determined work of changing our previous behavior. So, According to this stupid, unsaved Calvinist, we get salvation from Jesus, but it's based on us changing our previous behavior. It doesn't sound like that person believed that Jesus paid for all our sins, and that's why we have salvation. No, according to them, our salvation is based on us having a determined work of changing our previous behavior. This proves beyond a shadow of a doubt that Calvinists do not believe that Jesus paid for anything at the cross of Calvary. And my third proof of this is the simple fact that they believe in the perseverance of the saints. If they believed that Jesus paid it all, and that he died for all our sins, and that the barrier that needed to be removed between man and God was actuated by the cross work of Jesus, then there would be no requirement to persevere to the end. The only reason these people are persevering to the end is because their sins have not been paid for, because they're not saved, because they're still in their sins, and because they don't already have eternal life. It's that simple. So that's all I have. Like it or lump it, Calvinists do not believe that Jesus actually paid for sins, and their whole warped, stupid, damnable theology testifies to this. That's all I have. Let me go ahead and close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name, amen.
And tonight I lack the strength to even move. Walked, and I watched me die.